If you're a fan of platform and adventure games, you'll probably know a publisher called Humble Games. The studio is responsible for publishing good games such as Unsighted and Next Space Rebels and is almost known. The company was also tasked with publishing the first game of General Interactive Studios, Chinatown Detective Agency. This adventure effect falls under the point-and-click category and, of course, has RPG elements. Like the nationality of its manufacturer's studio, the story of the game takes place in Singapore. In the Chinatown area, a policeman named Amira Dharma, who redeemed herself early, works as a private detective and has a very creative and active mind to solve various cases. On a normal day, a close friend introduces her to a very wealthy client of a large and mysterious company. After meeting this person named Rupert Zhou, Amira finds out that a person named Philippe Ng, who was an executive of the company, is missing with a lot of money, and now you have a duty to find him. The story of the game is simple in appearance, but after a while it finds a lot of branches and you really need to have a good memory of remembering people's names. The game has no fear of the complexity of its fictional complexity, and given the proper payment of the characters, it is unlikely that you will simply forget someone and have to go back. Almost all minor characters also play an important role in the story, and no one gets in your way for no reason. For example, early in the game, with the arrival of Tiger Lily and Lucas Yeo, many plot twists will gradually happen that will attract you even more. The problem with the game's story is its slow process. For example, the first 5 cases of the game have a very good speed and make you more enthusiastic, but suddenly the game gets eroded and a few low-key cases get in your way that, although they have an impact on character characterization, they make that emotional process a stroke and blind your taste a little bit. If you can tolerate the mid-game a little bit and get acclimated to the game and characters, the game continues to take on a better process and offers a good story. The same gameplay as the Chinatown Detective Agency had not been seen in the stature of a high-quality game for a long time. Of course, for consoles I have to say that pointing-and-click games or edger side-scroll titles don't even reach the fingers of one hand, and except for titles like Machinarium and Full Throttle, there is no other good game in this genre for consoles. Fortunately, Chinatown Detective Agency expands this list. But what specific and attractive features does this title have in its gameplay? By entering the game, you'll encounter a crowded UI. Builders have taken a different trend than other games of this genre to travel between different places, cities, solving riddles and making decisions, which I will explain below. The important thing is that the Chinatown Detective Agency game doesn't look very attractive in images and videos, and it's also due to its pixel graphics and very simple. But this adventure game shows itself to experience it. To move the character, you can also click on interoperable objects and persons or moving her with the left analog. Also, the left side of the main character's mobile screen is interactable and you can dial in, read the news and call with your contacts. At the bottom of the page, there are 3 parts: map, hours and wait, each of which plays an important role in the game's advance. On the bottom right of the page is also a file name that can be checked by clicking on it, many parts such as file documents, clues, the latest dialogues, and more. Fortunately, the riddles of the game are very good quality and have a balanced degree of difficulty. In other words, they are not so hard to solve without guidance, nor are they so simple that the game takes on an easy and banal process. One of the interesting elements of the game is exactly this puzzle solving. In order to solve puzzles, you must either have good public information on issues such as the capitals of countries, cities, authors and books, or you need to, like a real detective, get a look at some of the things that have been said on the phone and learn from some names and topics on the internet, information that is directly effective in solving a case, a mystery, or the fate of a case. The game's puzzles are perfectly logical and in no way force you to do the odd things you do in other adventure games to solve riddles, such as combining unrelated material and going to unrelated places. On the other hand, everything has a logical process. In many cases, all your clues are from a 2-image file, and all you need to do is look at it and solve the hidden riddle of the file. In general, solving riddles bears a great resemblance to the reality of our world. I noted that the game has RPG elements. These elements are also embedded in the game's decision-making system, as well as in how the game is advanced, the optional file selection feature, and submissions. Unlike most games today, decisions are not in dialogues, and you change the process of the game by doing or not doing an original or optional job. For example, you can save or don't give your client an important flash drive in the fictional process, or don't give him this evidence by figuring out his evil goals and somehow just take the money and cheat his head. The commuter system, called hours, is one of the main parts of the game. you are repeatedly forced to travel between different cities of the world to resolve your cases, and in order to do so, you need to buy the destination ticket in this system first, and you have to buy the ticket so that you can be present at the airport 3 hours before the flight. Otherwise, the ticket money will be fueled and you will be left off the flight. When you arrive at the airport a little early, you can take a few hours to get on the plane by choosing the wait option to get on the plane faster. You may not even get a ticket that day for your destination, and you have to take the game forward one day with the wait option and then get on the plane. Inner city commutes are carried out by metro, and the name of the play areas comes from the real neighborhoods of Singapore. To select these areas, you need to select the map option and then select the metro station you want. Fortunately, the game is straightforward about which area you need to go to advance the main story, and it doesn't work confusingly for those who don't like RPG elements or don't want to do submissions. Finally, I have to point out the action scenes of the game, which require a quick response from the gamer to win, and you have to try to disarm the enemy and arrest him in these sequences. These sequences play an important role in the lack of repetitive gameplay and have worked well. One of the things I should mention is the save system. The save is only automatic until the end of the third case, after which save will be added manually. The problem with automatic save is that it only happens at the end of the case. Fortunately, the game fully supports Quick Resume and Xbox XS series users are not suffering from this loss. But for PC and PS5 users, this game feature is a bit annoying, although the first three files are short. The game's most valuable feature is its beautiful pixel graphics. Despite being pixelated, the game's graphics are eye-catching and benefit from good artistic graphics. The coloring of the game fits perfectly with its different cities, and its atmosphere also depicts a computer and robotic world in 2036. Perhaps the atmosphere of the game can be somewhat compared to the title of Ascent, where advanced robots have almost replaced humans. Animations are not so versatile, although they will probably satisfy you, and even try to show as many facial and body movements as possible in that simple graphic. Effects such as fire, rain and shooting are also very good included in the game. The sounding part of the game gets a perfect score. Almost all characters are voiced, and the lines of the dialogue are not low and banal, especially the sounding of the main character of the game, who expresses many dialogues in different tones and has done her job in a good way. The problem is playing in the music part, which after a while almost repeats, and the lack of it is felt in the middle of the game. Chinatown Detective Agency is a high-quality game in the adventure RPG genre, and it's unlikely that we'll see a better game in this genre for a long time, especially on consoles. With thoughtful and logical riddles, interesting RPG elements and pleasant graphics and sound, this game is a good option for those interested in this genre.